and a tremendous force at the plate. Will we get to see the big bat of Jay Bruce today? Our site for today's game, the Great American Ballpark, the home of the Reds. Gary Thorne, John Kreck, Steve Phillips, 2K Major League Baseball. Starting, it'll be Homer Bailey. Steve, as he's facing the San Francisco lineup today, what do you think's on his mind?
A good right-hander on the mound in this one. And if he executes the scouting report against this lineup, it shouldn't be too difficult for him to come up with the outs necessary to come away with a win.
We've got a chance to see how that lineup looks for the Giants. So who are you looking at, John?
Well, you got to love watching Hunter Pence play. When so many players nowadays are robotic players who have to do it one way and one way only, Hunter Pence can do it so many different ways. He throws sidearm from the outfield, but yet he seems to be at the top of the league in outfield assists every single season. Unorthodox, job done.
Getting us going, here is Angel Pagan. And Bailey tries inside. That'll go for a ball.
A front door two-seam fastball, trying to throw it inside, letting it tail back to the inside corner. Couldn't quite catch the corner, though.
Here's the 1-0. This one's grounded foul, wide of first. The pitch, lined right at the second baseman. One away. We'll take a quick look at the Reds and how they'll be lined up on the field. And how do you like who's out there, John?
Well, regardless of age, you can't help but want to watch Scott Rowan play the position of third base. He has been the best third baseman of his era. The guy makes all the plays, the routine play, it's an out. The strong throwing arm, the accurate throwing arm. Talk to first baseman that played with Scott Rowland. They said he's a joy to work with because every throw is chest high, right where you want it.
Strike started off the at-bat 0-1.
Well, they set up down and away. They throw it down and away. That's how you can be effective as a major league pitcher.
Down the line and right. And Bruce brings that one in. Now it's two away.
Had to run toward the line to be able to make this catch, but able to get there in plenty of time to put it away.
Sandoval at the plate, hitting 250 lifetime against Rookie of the Year, Homer Bailey. Swing and a miss on that curveball, it's 0-1.
Now that he's ahead in the count here, Gary, I'm looking for him to go to the curveball and try to punch him out.
Swings on the 0-1 pitch, can't hit it, strike two. He swings and nails a liner. Yeah, with two down, they've got a man on board. That's a really good pitch, Steve, on an 0-2 offering to keep that down and in.
That's a perfect pitcher's pitch. At this point, you've got to tip your hat to the batter. That's a solid job.
Now Buster Posey batting, runner at first. Bailey with a delivery. He swings now and really hit that. This one's going to be fielded by Stubbs. And that's out number three. No runs on a hit, and they'll scramble. And it'll be Ryan Vogelsong doing the pitching. He gets settled in for San Francisco. And Steve, as he faces these Cincinnati hitters, what do you think he's mainly concerned with?
Well, having bounced around quite a bit, Ryan Vogelsong has finally figured out what he is as a pitcher, and he knows how to use his stuff and doesn't try to do too much. There's nothing overpowering, but it's the sequencing of his pitches and the ability to throw them for strikes that allows him to be successful.
The pitch. Phillips grounds it. Sandoval gets it. And so Phillips retired. We've got a moment to check out that lineup for the Reds. John, who do we keep an eye on?
Well, like so many guys in baseball now, versatility in your lineup is key. Brandon Phillips is that guy in this lineup. He can hit leadoff. He can get on base. He can steal bases. You need him to hit fourth and hit the ball of the ballpark, he can do that for you, too. Very unselfish player. The glove we know is always there. The bat now, he's starting to come along, and that's what makes him so dangerous.
And Vogelsong's wide that time. That's going to be a ball.
Well, the Cincinnati team is built around its offense. In 2011, put a ton of runs on the board, second only to the St. Louis Cardinals. That kept them right around the 500 mark. The pitching was the question.
1-1 pitch is a cut fastball taken for a strike, 1-2. And certainly for the Reds, staying around 500 when you had the Brewers and Cardinals playing the way they were, John, that just wasn't going to be enough.
Yeah, going forward, I think improving their starting pitching is their most pressing need. Last season, Mike Leake was the only Red starter to crack the 10-win barrier.
Well, he finished that one off with a strikeout. Nice pitch. We'll take a look here and see where the Giants are positionally around the diamond. Highlights, John, from these fielders?
Yeah, Hunter Pence. You know, so many guys are so robotic, and they're taught to play the game one way. And if that was the case, Hunter Pence would never be in the big leagues. Very unorthodox, but check the leader every year with outfield assist, and Hunter Pence is going to be on the board.
Here's the delivery. And the pitch is taken for a strike by Votto. He's 1-for-3 off Vogelsong. Strike two. Joey Votto may have to cut down on that swing a little here.
Tough spot for the hitter right here. Down 0-2. You got to foul off that tough pitch if you have to.
And that one swung on and missed by Joey Votto. Good defensive half inning there. No hits allowed. No runs put up yet in Cincinnati. Cincinnati overcast here today, folks. A little bit of a gray day, but our game moving on. Hunter Pence in the box. He'll start it off here in the second. The 0-0 delivery, a fastball taken for a strike. Here's a swing, and he pops him up. This one to Phillips. That's one away.
He swung hard like he wanted to drive this one, but got underneath it. Winds up just popping it up the second.
Brandon Belt batting now with one down. Seven ABs. He's picked up one hit off the Reds. Fouled away. Homer Bailey, he gets that in his favor. He gets that count to 0-2.
Well, he recognized that two-seamer. It seemed like his timing was right there, but he tried to turn on it and just came up empty.
And a swing and a miss. Strike three to Brandon Bell.
Let's watch K-Cam. Take a look at the two-seam fastball.
It's going to be Blanco now. That one's drilled to short. That one gets through for a base hit.
Oh, I love being able to get hits with two outs. Even if there's no one on base, you don't drive in any runs. What it does is, though, it prolongs the inning, and it makes the opposing pitcher work harder and can possibly get him out of the game earlier.
And Crawford's in the box. A ball there as Bailey misses.
Well, Gary, this guy has an outstanding slider. Such a tough pitch to hit. It almost needs a turn signal when it gets to the plate.
Fastball misses badly. He's behind 2-0.
Well, Gary, talk about his slider. What makes it so tough to hit him is that the break on that pitch is so big and it's so hard, it's very tough on the hitter to center the ball.
2-1 pitch, a fastball. Swung on and missed, 2-2.
I wouldn't be surprised if they go with a fastball right here. The numbers indicate he struggles with two strikes on that heater.
Now the 2-2. Fastball well off the mark, and it's full 3-2.
A good action on that pitch running away, but it's a ball you have to get down to the zone. Don't throw it up.
Now the pitch to Crawford. And he looks at a fastball that's in there, side retired. No runs on a base hit. They leave one man on at first. Still. Leadoff hitter Ryan Ludwig. And a swinging strike on the first pitch by Vogelsong, 0-1. And that's a strike. Ryan Ludwig's going to have to be careful now, close to being put away. Ludwig makes contact. He'll foul it away. A swing and a miss for strike three on Ryan Ludwig.
Now we're going to get a chance, Gary, to see the four-seam fastball in K-Camp.
Two straight fastballs. He still couldn't catch up with it.
Well, the pitcher comes back with a fastball right after he threw one and gets the K. You know he's throwing gas out there.
And Jay Bruce digs in. There's one away.
Well, the Giants traveled pretty well last season. Not as well as they did in the championship 2010 season. Just under 500 in 2011.
The fastball is in there. It's 0-1. And there's always the issue, Steve, talking about the Giants away, about traveling to the East Coast. The team struggled, John, because of that long trip.
Yeah, that's possible. I mean, there's definitely more travel for the West Coast teams than the East Coasters. I'll say that much.
That's hit foul by Bruce. There's a ground ball. Scudero makes the play.
He's up.
Two down. And it's Scott Rowland in the box now. Four hits, 10 at bats, a lifetime against Vogelsong. Here's the delivery. Takes that first pitch low in the strike zone, strike one.
You know, with an 0-1 count, we usually see him go with the heater. Sometimes he goes against grain, but I think you have to go with the trend.
Here's a swing and a ground ball. Crawford throws on to first in time to retire the side. Nobody left on base. No runs or hits here in this half inning. No runs put up yet in Cincinnati. And if you're just joining in, Gary Thorne with Steve Phillips and John Kroc bringing you Major League Baseball here on 2K Sports. Vogelsong at the plate now. He's going to start the third here. 0-1 is the count now as we get going in the third. And of course, as a pitcher, you got to keep your eye on which pitcher. Here's a swing and a line drive. And in there, base hit. Opposing pitcher, that is tough to take when you're on the mound. And that's going to bring Angel Pagan up.
Gary, he may have surprised himself right there. Good piece of hitting by the pitcher. Hey, nothing like giving yourself a little offensive support.
Grounded out his last time through. First pitch on the way. There's a swing and a drive. Deep right field. One away. And he'll have to hold at first. And we're going to see Scudero here. One out, man on first. And that's in there. Bailey ahead now, 0-1.
Some guys really like the low fastball. In this situation, though, he ends up taking...
Headed for the middle. Oh, my. How did he get out of the way of that? Those are scary. But he stays with it. Gets the out. That's how you do it.
Heads-up play by the pitcher, showing his athleticism, wheeling to get the lead runner at second. They just couldn't turn two.
Sandoval at the plate. He singled his last trip and starts him out here. And Bailey tries inside. That'll go for a ball.
That curveball inside right there. Pretty good pitch, but if he leaves.
Swing, hot shot, the diving stop, and he's up with it. Throws in time to first. What a play. Homer Bailey, some nice work on the mound. He has a shutout through three innings of work. And it'll be the Reds coming up next. And we've got Stubbs here. He's our first batter, home half of the third inning. Strike there as he watches Vogelsong's pitch.
Look, Gary, I think he decided that was a pitch he needed to take as soon as it came out of his hand. Just can't handle that fastball up and away.
Good cut fastball that time. He's in control with the count at 0-2. Ground ball by Stubbs. Crawford. One down.
Well, Gary, he's pitching well right now. And that's seven straight that he's retired. He is really locked in.
And we've got Hannigan here standing in. He's 2-for-3, lifetime off Ryan Vogelsong. Posey calls for the pitch. He watches the first pitch. That ends up in the zone. Strike one.
At the start of last season, if I'd have told you that Ryan Vogelsong would have one of the best ERAs in the league and be an all-star, you would have probably laughed at me and thought I was crazy. I am, but he did it.
And wow. This is bounced foul to the left side. For Vogelsong, what a comeback story, really. He spent a couple of years in the Japanese leagues playing and out of nowhere became one of the game's best.
Well, what a story of perseverance. A guy who kind of stuck with it, overcame injuries, you know, having to go out of the country to reinvent himself. And he's come back and is a quality pitcher right now. He knows what he is and what he isn't.
And Bailey's batting. Watches a fastball that's in there. 0-1. The pitch. And here's a swing and a miss, and he falls behind 0-2. Oh, man, there's the big bender. Struck him outside, retired. Three up, three down for Ryan Vogelsong. And here's Buster Posey. And the first pitch. And he got the bat on that one. Ludwig's there. That one's glove.
Well, he just got under this one. A left fielder able to make an easy catch.
One out. Hunter Pence at the plate. He popped out his last time. This one swung on and driven hard. This one's going to be fielded by Stubbs. And he grabs it in his tracks. And it's belt batting. Let's take a look at how this pitcher has been utilizing his arsenal of pitches.
I think he's throwing that 12-6 curveball just a little bit too much. I think he needs to mix things up a little bit more to make that pitch more effective.
You know, it's interesting. I don't know why. You know, the scouting report is that he goes to that four-seam fastball for his outs. For whatever reason, he's not going there. But I think he needs to get back into that routine of what makes him successful.
And Bailey tries inside. That'll go for a ball.
Oh, Gary, into the fourth inning right here now. They've gotten three hits in this one, so they've had a few base runners, but they haven't been able to lump them together to be able to generate any runs so far.
That one is hit well. Stubbs there. And that one's put away to retire the side. How about that? Only need. And welcome to those of you just tuning in, 2K Sports, Major League Baseball. This is Gary Thorne along with Steve Phillips and John Crook. And Brandon Phillips to bat. Called strike from Vogelsong and the count is 0-1.
Well, climbing the ladder with that four-seam fastball, trying to get the hitter to elevate his eyes. He gets the strike on it, and the hitter doesn't pull the trigger.
A bouncing ball to shortstop, and it goes foul. Low and away with that one. It's 1-2.
Well, he struggles against the curveball with two strikes, so don't be surprised if that's what he sees in this situation.
Here it comes.
Foul!
It's hit foul by Phillips. Swinging the ball, hit softly towards the hole. Belt able to put that one away.
Well, the hitter made contact, but didn't make solid contact as the first baseman was there to easily pull that one in.
And we've got Cozart batting. And Steve, his name appears when you look at Dusty Baker's offensive plan. And a swinging strike on the first pitch by Vogelsong, 0-1. Let's take a look here at how he's been mixing up his pitches so far in this game.
And you know what I've been noticing? Even before...
Now here's a grounder towards the hole. On to first, two away.
Now Gary, he just continues to mow this lineup down. We're talking about 11 hitters in a row retired.
Here's Joey Votto, batting with two down. He's averaged .298 lifetime against the Giants. Here's the first pitch. Swung on and missed, 0-1.
Well, he threw in the cutter right there, and it looked like he was trying to chase that one. Be patient, young man. It'll get there.
And Joey Votto watches that one go by. Count is even. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Started to go around, but a called strike, 1-2. And Joey Votto watches that one go by. Count is even.
The best curveballs are the ones that start in the strike zone, then fall out of the strike zone. He couldn't get him to fish for that one, though.
Strike three. Joey Votto swings right through that one. That'll send him packing. You could not ask for a better four innings. So far, everything's working.
A dozen up and a dozen down. You can't stop.
It's going to be Blanco now.
Now, we've seen Bailey good before, but never this good. He is dominating this team.
How's he delivering on these first pitches? Let's look and see.
Well, Gary, you work behind in the count. You go 1-0. It gives the aggressiveness back to the hitter. And, you know, he's given up a couple hits in this game when he's falling behind on that first pitch.
Swung on, liner to right. And that one is in there, his second hit today.
Well, this guy's always a threat to go. He steals a lot of bases, so they're going to have to keep a close eye on him, and maybe they'll make a mistake to the hitter paying attention to the runner.
And Crawford's in the box. Earlier in the game, first AB, he was struck out against Bailey.
Well, that four-seam fastball just locked him up the last time around. He had no chance to get the bat off his shoulder for strike three.
First pitch he let go by, and it was a ball, 1-0.
Well, Gary, they've only left a couple runners on base offensively so far through the middle part of this ballgame, and you know, they're going to have to give themselves more opportunities to see if they can't come up with that big base hit. That's just not enough offense.
This is an opening for San Francisco.
Well, he's still able to pull the ball here because he was out in front of it, but the key to hitting the breaking ball.
And he lays one down here. Hannigan. And his throw gets him. One away.
You have to be willing to do things for the team. That's what he does right there, getting a quality sack bunt down, getting a runner in scoring position, and getting praise from his teammates.
Foul ball!
We've got Angel Pagan in the box. Swings and grounds this one foul, wide a third. Hit in the air, in right, foul territory. And Bruce gets to... Here comes the runner for the plate. The first runs in easily.
I'll tell you what, this is what you want to do. Get runners on in front of this guy, and he knows how to capitalize. Sometimes he knows he needs the big base hit. This time he knew. Put it in play, pick up the run.
And we're going to see Scudero here. Offensive production. Boy, does that look good as you move along later into a ball game, and they've got a lead.
You know, Gary, that at-bat we just saw could prove to be the most critical at-bat in this ball game. They want to keep adding on to the lead.
Could be one of those situations that decides the ball game. Right now, it looks like their offense is ready to start clicking. That one's wide as Bailey misses.
Now, Gary, as you were saying, that was one of those situations where they had the opportunity and they capitalized. And this offense does look like it's heating up. Let's see if they can keep it going here.
Strike two. A swing and a miss by Michael Scudero. Count knotted up. Changing the eye level of hitters is such a key component. Here we can see the breakdown of how this guy has been mixing locations.
His command and control have been solid. Not perfect, but the great pitching coaches will all agree that when you can mix locations along with pitch types, that you have the greatest chance of success each time out on the mound.
And John, you know this is a game of adjustments, and the hitters have not been able to adjust to the location and the rhythm of his pitching.
And here's the 3-2. And he heads down to first base. That's ball four.
That's good plate discipline by the hitter right now. Good pitch recognition. Laying off the ball out of the zone.
We will now see in this key moment Pablo Sandoval, 1-for-2 in the ballgame. Scudero's the runner at first. On its second is Crawford. There's a swing and a ground ball. And he's in trouble. He's tagged out between first and second. Now we finally hear a whimper out of the offense. They put a run across. The Giants lead it 1-0. For those of you just joining in, I'm Gary Thorne along with John Kruk and Steve Phillips. We bring you Major League Baseball here on 2K Sports. And in the batter's box, it's Ludwig. Vogelsong sets and throws. And Ludwig lets it go outside for a ball. So far, 0-for-1, looking to get his first hit off Vogelsong.
He struck out last time with a four-seam fastball. He's got to be ready for it now, which may make him vulnerable for an off-speed pitch.
And he looks at a fastball in there, 1-1.
Now that he's established the strike zone down and in, he can elevate a pitch or go with something soft away from the hitter.
Posey calls for the pitch. And it's a called strike to Ludwig.
Boy, a great career performance from Vogelsong in this one.
Now a moment here to look at the quality strikes this pitcher's been throwing here today. Boy, he has thrown a ton of them. Quality pitches, quality strikes. That's the kind of performance we're seeing.
Yeah, and I've been impressed with how he's used the inner and outer parts of the strike zone. Very effective in getting a lot of strikes on these hitters.
You know, it's been difficult for the hitters to center him because he hasn't thrown the ball over the middle portion of the plate, keeping it on the corners.
And Jay Bruce digs in. There's one away.
Well, you can see it coming with the way he ended 2010. 2011, though, another outstanding year from Jay Bruce, showing a lot of power.
And here's the first one. Swing sets this one pretty well. Deep right center. And Pagan's there. Roms over, puts it away.
Well, they followed the advanced scouting reports to a T. They played the outfielders back that time, and he hit it right into the teeth of the defense.
Scott Rowland, he'll get the swing now with two away. Called strike from Vogelsong, and the count is 0-1. Well, it's truly been a tremendous day on the mound for this man. Here's a breakdown of how he's been mixing up his locations, using that to his advantage.
But we've been watching him go high, go low. He's forcing this lineup to think a lot, and when hitters think, they're done.
And it makes it hard to swing confidently when they don't have their bearings in the box. They don't know location or speed, and right now they're just swinging over the top of everything.
Curveball in there for a called strike, three, side retired. Well, you don't want to say anything too early, but through five, folks, there ain't anything up there.
And you know what? Second time through the lineup, they're not making any.
And it's Buster Posey standing in. He'll get things started off as we go to the sixth. Swung on by Posey. Hammers that one. And that is gone. San Francisco keeps pouring it on. So that narrow one-run lead is now doubled on one swing of the bat as he got it out of here.
Well, what a time for the Giants offense to get the job done, continuing to build the lead.
And so Pence retired. That's one down. And it's belt batting. Here's the first pitch. Big swing and a miss. Strike one. Shot towards the hole. And Votto picks it up. And he steps on first. That's the second out.
Now first baseman showing good hands and good feet, making the play there and taking it easily himself.
It's going to be Blanco now. These at-bats, how's he starting them? Let's take a look.
Big advantage for the offense when they are able to kind of sit up.
He swings and drives this one. This one's going to be fielded by Stubbs. And the side's retired as they head into the dugout. So they pick up a run on the home run and add to their lead. San Francisco by two. And we've got Stubbs here. The first pitch. Called strike from Vogelsong and the count is 0-1.
You know, I know we're not supposed to say anything about no-hitters, so I would never say anything about that, Gary. But
don't worry.
You know, I don't think they have any hits here. And we're, you know, moving through the middle part of the ballgame.
0-1. Good hard cutter in for a called strike.
All the pressure on the hitter right now. He knows that he has to protect the plate in order not to strike out.
Ball. Good cutter there, but it's 1-2 now.
Well, he didn't chase that one. That pitch down and away. Good movement on the cut fastball. He just laid off of it. It's a pitch with two strikes. You better be swinging at, though.
Strike three, swung on. Drew Stubbs, no contact. I'll tell you something, Steve. He keeps pitching like this, the murmurs are going to start.
Well, you can hear the chatter in the stands right now. People starting to recognize a lot of zeros up on that scoreboard. Every manager likes to have a guy like this coming off the bench, a guy with a little pop in his bat. If you need a big home run, he's the guy to go to.
He swings on that 0-0 delivery, misses the fastball. Strike one.
Well, clearly the pitcher's in control right here. This guy really struggles on the fastball when he's behind in the count, so look for the heat.
That's strike two, and he's behind. Ryan Vogelsong in charge now.
Well, that's a great location down in the strike zone with that curveball. And like the right there, he got a swing and miss. But even if they make contact, you're going to get a grounder somewhere to your infield.
Line drive. And it's caught. Play by Scudero.
Well, Gary, he just keeps stretching this hitless streak even further. We're talking about 17 hitters retired in a row.
And Bailey's batting. Struck out swinging last time. Here's the first pitch. It's now 0-1. Watch that fastball go by. Here's the pitch. Second pitch waves at the fastball, and suddenly it's strike two. Lined foul towards third. Here's the pitch. And that's the inning. Wow, he ends it with a strikeout, and he is perfect through six.
And that's the.
And Crawford's in the box. Last trip to the plate came away with a nice single off Bailey.
Well, this lineup not having much trouble.
Line fair down the line and right. And it gets down. That's hit number two, making good contact.
Well, a good piece of hitting right there. And anytime you get your first hitter of the inning on base, it could set up the potential for a big inning.
And Vogelsong settles in. What do you think? Drops down a bunt. And Navarro, the ground ball. In time for the out.
Now listen, pitchers don't hit the ball as well as position players do, but you can still impact the game with productive outs. Good punt.
Boy, will he be happy if that comes around to score.
That's going to make the manager very happy right there.
At bat, hit up the middle. Oh, my, he manages to get the glove on that. Talk about reflexes.
This is the pitcher's worst nightmare. You throw the pitch and it comes right back at you. Sometimes it's just self-defense. He got the glove up and made the out. A lot riding on Marco Scudero's at bat right here. You can see the determination in his face.
Walked in his last plate appearance. And out. Pitcher makes a nice play at first base.
That was a nice play. Saw the opportunity at first. Didn't waste any time getting over. That's the key. Beat the runner to the bag.
Good hustle off the mound. No strikeouts, but you talk about confidence. And so Brandon Phillips leading it off. The first pitch. Called strike from Vogelsong, and the count is 0-1.
I don't know about you, Gary, but when I look up the board under that H column, the hits column, I see a big goose egg there. So clearly, we're getting into exciting territory right now.
And it's 0-2. Phillips trying to avoid the strikeout.
Well, if you're going to be late on the fastball, you're going to have trouble hitting up here, and he's struggling right now.
Here's the pitch.
Foul!
It's hit foul by Phillips. Strikes him out, and he's still flawless with one out in the seventh inning.
Well, one more hitter down, and these hitters are going to have to start to make some adjustments right now. They've got to be more aggressive early in the count.
And we've got Cozart batting. Grounded out his last time up. Smashes that one towards the shortstop. And a good throw gets him two down.
Well, he has great stuff. There's no question about that. And every time he takes the mound, he's got a shot at something like this special happening. This may be the day that it comes to fruition.
Here's Joey Votto batting with two down. 0-for-2 thus far. Vogelsong's pitch and can't find the zone. When you see a pitching performance like we've seen from the man on the mound today, there have to be a lot of things going right, and they have been. Here's a breakdown of how often he's gotten those hitters to chase pitches outside the zone.
Well, he's been very effective today, and you look at the performance, he's generating strikes with pitches out of the zone, getting the hitters to chase.
Oh, absolutely, Steven. You know, you want to try to expand the strike zone. You start in the strike zone early and then try to make them chase. That's what he's had these hitters doing all game.
He watches the fastball go by. Now it's 2-2. The 2-2 pitch. Hit in the dirt. Sandoval gets it. He'll throw on to first, and that'll do it for this half inning.
Now as we get deeper into the game, he's got to be thinking himself.
And if you just joined our broadcast, great to have you on board. 2K Sports Major League Baseball, I'm Gary Thorne with Steve Phillips and John Krupp. Sandoval gets a turn here. He's going to get us started, eighth inning. And the 1-0 count getting us going here in the eighth. Here's the 1-0. Outside as Sandoval takes it for a ball. Now the 2-0.
Ball
three, and now the three-ball count brings Pablo Sandoval an opportunity to be selected.
Well, he has to just settle down, concentrate on this next pitch. You get behind 3-0, you don't want to walk the leadoff hitter. Throw a quality strike right here and see what happens.
Well, this one out of the zone, down and in, and now walks him on four straight pitches.
Now the opportunity's there for Buster Posey. This is a swing hit in the air. And another foul ball.
Well, the way to extend it at bat is to spoil the pitcher. When he throws that pitch on the corner, fight it off.
This one's pretty well hit to deep left center. Ludwig to field this one. And he meanders over to put it away.
Well, he hit this one well, but it hangs up long enough to give the left fielder just enough time to run underneath and make the catch.
Now, Hunter Pence. Sandoval the lead at first. Bailey with a delivery. And a ground ball. There's Roland. Gets one. And a double play. No runs, no hits. Nobody crossed the plate in this half inning, and nobody left on base. Now, the Reds. Leadoff hitter Ryan Ludwig. So far in the game, he has struck out twice against Vogelsong.
But I couldn't quite pick up the cutter the last time up, striking out on that pitch. And you know he's got to look for it a little bit here and try to speed up that bat.
Yeah, and I mean, this time through, as a hitter, you've got to adjust to what he's already shown you.
That one swung on a miss by Ryan Ludwig, and that strike evens it up.
No runs, no hits. Deep, deep into this ballgame, Gary, and obviously he is pitching a gem of a game.
Call fastball, now the count 1-2.
Now 1-2 is a pitcher's count, so there's no reason to give him a good pitch to hit right here.
The 1-2 pitch. And he leaves that one alone. Ryan Ludwig shows patience. That'll even up the count.
Now, Gary, he's in a little bit of trouble right now. With two strikes, they're probably going to try to get him to chase that curveball.
Struck him out. And the countdown continues. Hold your hand up, folks. That's 5 outs away from this piece of history.
Well, if the next 5 outs come as easily as that one did, he will get this perfect game. He is just dazzling them with his outstanding stuff.
And Jay Bruce digs in this one away. Last time up, flew out. And starts him out here. First pitch, a big breaker for a called strike.
You don't get many curveballs like this from this guy. He doesn't hang very many. He made a mistake. You have to make him pay for the mistakes.
And that's a strike. Bruce is going to have to take a little defensive stance here. He deals. Got him. Two down. Eighth inning. Now he is just 4 outs away from a piece of baseball immortality.
Well, look at him walking back to the dugout, shaking his head. He has baffled this lineup the entire game right now. They just can't seem to find a hole and put the ball in play.
Scott Rowland, 0 for 2 thus far. And he starts him out. And he offers at the circle change and misses 0-1. There's a swing, and that one's hit on the ground. And he'll scramble, take it himself for the out. Whoa, what a play.
Well, he's gone through 8 right now. He's got an inning ahead of him, 3 more outs, and has let the celebration begin.
Here's Brandon Belt leading it off. He bounced out his last time. And the first pitch. Swung on, a drive by Belt. And that is gone. San Francisco keeps pouring it on. And another solo home run, extending the lead now to 3.
Well, what a time for the
line shot into center field. And it's through. That's a base hit. And with that right-hander warming up in the bullpen here, I'm not sure quite what they're thinking.
Well, with the left-handed hitter on deck, he's probably getting ready for hitters later in the lineup.
And Crawford's in the box. Things going his way so far in this one. A pair of hits and 2 for 3 against Bailey.
If I'm up to bat, I'm looking for another fastball early in the count that I can drive. He's seen it once. You know he's able to get around on it, and it doesn't lock him up. He's got to be able to put that ball in play.
Pauses, and now the 1-0 to left center. And that'll put him on another hit.
Well, you're talking about a guy who's swinging a pretty hot bat right now. His third hit of this ball game, and it comes with nobody out in the inning.
Well, the pressure starts to mount for Homer Bailey. He just hopes he doesn't have to give up a homer.
And he has 2 men on with nobody out. A base hit here would probably put this game out of reach.
Well, you're right, Gary. They've got to find a way to get out of this inning without giving up a run, or this could end up in the loss column.
The pitch, and again, he fights off Homer Bailey. Swinging a high chopper towards the hole. And that's out number 1 as he takes it to the bag.
High!
Now, this was an outstanding performance today. I mean, that's good starting pitching right there. He won't be able to finish what he started, but he pitched a heck of a ball game.
For his career, 321 up. This one's going to be fielded by Stubbs. Out. Nope. Here comes the runner for the plate. And that first run scores.
Well, at the end of the year, we're going to be talking about the numbers this guy puts up, and it's because in these sorts of situations, he finds a way to get the job done.
And we're going to see Scudero here. And the offense here is putting on the show right now. They're in charge of this ballgame.
Well, they keep tacking on runs right here, extending the lead. That's a big hit now.
There's a ground ball. And Votto picks it up. And they'll record the out at first base. Good timing on that play.
They might not have been able to get him out at the plate, but a short run over to the first, and he still retires his man.
Well, they add a couple. And for those of you just joining in, I'm Gary Thorne, along with John Kruk and Steve Phillips. We bring you Major League Baseball here on 2K Sports. And we've got Stubbs here, 0 for 2 thus far. And a swinging strike on the first pitch by Vogelsong, 0-1.
Well, Gary, in the ninth inning, has not given up a hit in this one, so we may be looking at some history for him personally and for his club.
Fastball swung on, can't make contact, and behind on the count 0-2.
Well, great movement on that two-seamer right there. Had him way out on his front foot.
Foul ball!
Hit foul by Stubbs. Vogelsong sets and throws. Gets him on strikes. There's one here in the ninth inning.
Hey, there's one thing to get a perfect game. It's another one to just keep mounting the strikeouts.
Navarro at the plate. He'll get his first look in this one. This one's grounded near third. Foul. Oh, 1, Vogelsong kicks and delivers. There's a big swing and a miss. 0-2. A swing and a foul off to the right side. Fouled off.
When you're down on the count 0-2, you want to battle and fight any way you can to stay alive. He fouled off a tough pitch right there.
There's a smash towards the hole. And he steps on first. That's the second out. Only one more. How close, how close. But you still got to get that final out.
Everyone across the nation has their eyes set on him. The command of his pitches, great stuff. We'll see if he can close it out.
Swings on that first pitch, misses the fastball, 0-1. Vogelsong sets and throws. Swing and a ball popped foul to the left side.
Foul ball!
Swing and a miss, and there it is. A perfect game. What a performance.
Gary, I don't think there's a better feeling in sports than mastering your craft. He was absolutely unhittable all game long. Now he's going to go down with the other legends of the game for his accomplishments today.
And Steve, they say it takes a little luck, but when you get a game like that, you'll take it.
Well, it takes luck and talent, and boy, does he have the talent. A tough loss here for this crowd today, but boy, do they see some kind of pitching performance from the visiting team.
Now it's time to present our player of the game. Fantastic display in this one, Ryan Vogelsong.
Well, you know, they don't call it a perfect game for nothing. This is something that this young man will remember for the rest of his life. And everyone who's here has to have a feeling that they just witnessed some sort of history. And I know, never playing in one in my career, a perfect game, I'm thankful I got to see this one.
And we witnessed a pitcher who has put himself in the record book, an incredible, perfect game.
I mean, you see history made here with this kind of performance from this guy, an outstanding effort, and they get the win as a team as well to move forward.
So glad you could join us. For Steve Phillips and John Kruk, I'm Gary Thorne. We'll see you real soon.